Welcome to Horizon League Basketball tonight on ESPNU. Halfway through the first half, first lead of the game moments ago for the Ramblers of Loyola against Wright State. Jim Barber, Malcolm Huckabee, who started Boston College. Little penetrating kick, three ball for Wright State from the corner by Vest. It's missed and saved by Devin Turk, who moments ago had two threes to help Loyola gain its first lead. This is Jeff White. O'Leary in trouble. Didn't move his feet though, and on the drive to the goal has the ball deflected. These are the two best teams by the numbers in the Horizon League defensively, not allowing more than 56 points a game to their opponents. Wright State with a win tonight. Would stay even with Detroit in first place in the Horizon League. Actually, in the loss column, would stay even and would move a half a game ahead at 4-0. Titans, big winners over Youngstown State the other evening, 101-60. This is Cully Payne. Kendall Griffin set his feet, decided to attack the goal, and gets a blocking foul. Take a look at our one-on-one tonight, and it begins with the guard play and two very important point guards for these two teams.
Two of the top point guards out of the Horizon League for Wright State, Reggie Arsenault, averaging close to 10 points a game, three assists. He's really the guy that sets the pace for them on the offensive end. And then for Loyola, Cully Payne, having a tremendous season for them thus far, 8 points a game, leading the Horizon League in assists with close to five per game.
Pain with injuries and the necessary transfer when you leave schools. Getting to see some significant action finally, and he popped out as the first guy tonight. I said to him, hey, first man out. He says, always.
Yeah, he's really an interesting story. Started off, as you said, at Iowa. Had a great freshman campaign and, you know, really had shown some promise, and then he got injured, coaching change, and really hasn't played basketball for the last 2 years.
Big time steal by Kendall Griffin. And we have our second tie at 17-17 as we dip under 9 minutes for the first half. The Ramblers, who won only seven games all last year, have already won 10, and really haven't been playing well as of late, according to the coach. They are exceeding expectations, are they not?
Well, even if they were playing great, coaches are never happy or satisfied.
Part of the job description, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Arsenault on the kickback for a three from the outside. It's a little long, back iron. Kendall Griffin tracks it down. That's a good look from Cole Darling, but he misses. That's Christian Thomas for the rebound. Ramblers down the other way to Ben Aberkamp, and it's stuck on the goal. Hell ball, possession arrow gives it to the Ramblers here on this side of the court with 8:11 to go.
We're going to take a look. That's a nice pass up the court that time by Cully Payne, and Arsenault couldn't finish right there, but that's something that both defensive teams, when you come in, they get stopped. They try to get out in transition and get some easy buckets.
And to this point, three Ramblers have scored, led by Devin Turk with 8 and 7 from Ben Aberkamp, combining for 15 of the team's 17. Wright State led in scoring by Reggie Arsenault, who has 6, and he has the ball. Miles Dixon, they're pretty high on him, are they not?
They are. They like his offense. Of course, we just jinxed him.
But he got it back. And Arsenault gets a nice look. Jeff White with that second motor trying to attack the goal.
Nice move by the 6'1 freshman from Aurora, Illinois. And his dad was a pretty good player back in the day. Played for Bradley back in the late 80s.
1,000-point score, 1,107 points to be exact. Ramblers on a run, leading by 2, 19-17. White against the goal. Jack Thomas. What's allowing Jeff White to get out into the open court like this?
Well, he is awfully fast in transition right here. And Wright State doing a poor job in transition defense. That's twice now that White has been able to get down the court and get really easy layups right there. And that's the type of stuff that no coach wants to see, a guy going the length of the court, nobody stepping in and cutting off dribble penetration.
And this is a 17-7 run for the Ramblers. Happy to be back in their own confines for a game. They lost a home game a little while back. They did not expect to lose against Youngstown State by two. In conference play, Wright State and Detroit start play tonight at 3-0. Then the Crusaders of Valpo, and then there is a five-way wedge between Loyola, Illinois, UIC, Youngstown State, Cleveland State, and Green Bay, and Milwaukee. In the process of rebuilding, is at the bottom at 0-2. What did Donlin tell us? There should have been a seven-way tie from the media for that third position because of all the upheaval and the changes with some of the teams.
I like that comment. Just make it a seven-way tie. You know Valparaiso, Detroit were the two top teams, and everybody else, there's a lot of parity in the Horizon League right now.
Push off on Wright State and number 30, Joe Bramante. 6:45 remains in a defensive battle so far. ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by the Capital One Cash Rewards Card with a 50% annual bonus, and by Ram Trucks, Guts, Glory, Ram.
Want to know what I did in the last 5 hours?
I played a round of golf.
And then I read a book while teaching myself how to play guitar.
Ran 10 miles while knitting myself a sweater. Jumped out of a plane.
Finally, I became a ping pong master.
While recording
my debut album.
How, you ask? With 5-hour energy. I get hours of energy now, no crash later. Wait to see the next 5 hours.
And he's like a hero.
Been a hero.
It was a heroic effort.
Every day we bring to our fans the world of sports. We speak of heroes and heroism, but there are days when sports matter little and heroes matter more. These heroes don't hit walk-off homers or buzzer-beating threes. They simply made a plan for what to do when disaster strikes. You never know when you might need to be the hero, because you never know if today is the day before a natural disaster. Prepare, plan, be a hero. Visit ready.gov.
When is a bargain not a bargain? When you pay a whole lot more and get a whole lot less. Take Dish's introductory price. After just 3 months, it triples. And in 12 months, the same TV package costs four times more. That's clearly not a bargain. And not only will you pay four times more, but you still won't get any of these top-rated channels. So don't be fooled by Dish. The best channels for the best price. Another reason 30 million people agree. Don't just watch TV, DirecTV.
Think you're stuck paying high auto insurance rates because of your driving record? Then now is the time to change the game. Just go to thegeneral.com or call us for a super fast quote. All it takes is a couple of minutes. Our rates are very affordable, and right now our monthly payments are as low as $39. You'll also get instant proof of insurance.
Show off.
For a great low rate you can get online, go to the General and save some time.
It's the Ramblers 21 and the Raiders 17 with 6:45 remaining in the first half on ESPNU. Big difference in this game, bench scoring by Loyola, led by Devin Turk.
And they're so high on this kid, Jim, a freshman from Houston, Texas. I talked about it earlier. He had 21 points in 24 minutes versus Mississippi State earlier in the year. An explosive scorer that can get his shot off from anywhere in the court.
And you mentioned Texas. His high school is no ordinary high school. Westbury Christian has won 16 of the last 22 state championships.
That is an impressive number right there.
Ramblers in their home white with the basketball and a two-score lead here in the first half. And Rick Hartzell spots contact inside on the Raiders. ESPNU Saturday Showcase features a trio of great games. At noon, Big East Marquette squaring off against Trey Woodall and Pitt. Then at 2, Big 12. Sheldon McClellan leads Texas against Iowa State, and at 4, SEC. Kenny Boynton and the Gators face LSU. Saturday Showcase presented by 5-Hour Energy. Coverage tips at noon on ESPNU. And also live on Watch ESPN. Marquette off to a good start in conference play at 2-0, led by Devontae Gardner, who averages 12 points a game and 5 rebounds. Kendall Griffin just picked up personal foul for Wright State, his first, team 7th, so the bonus is in effect for Loyola. Christian Thomas out of St. Louis, Missouri, and Porter Moser, along with Rick Majerus, scouting the St. Louis area many years back, and Thomas popped up.
It's interesting how he said he's been on this kid for a very long time, and they're glad to have him here.
Wright State missing 8 consecutive three-point attempts after Reggie Arsenault hit a couple early. Contact spotted inside, just the 4th team foul on the Ramblers. Son Nick Osborne, his first. Ramblers already doubling their total against Green Bay the other night, which they had just 12 first half points. Griffin Arsenault still shooting the 3. We'll make that a long 2 in this case, and Arsenault with those 2 points, now along with his 2 threes, has 8.
Jim, Wright State is getting some really good looks on the offensive end, and that time Arsenault was able to knock it down, and earlier in this game, they've been getting some wide open looks from the perimeter.
Osborne misses inside, it is out of bounds, and off of Christian Thomas. Billy Donlin and his father, Bill Donlin, senior, on the bench now with the Raiders this year. That's a look at Junior, who his dad said looked as if he was going to be a coach back in his high school days, with a focus and determination and his pride in playing the game. His dad is director of basketball operations. He is on the bench tonight, as he is for every game, and he was hired in the offseason. We spoke to dad and son today, and his dad said, you know, I had to think about whether to join Billy on the bench, whether this was good for him as a coach and good for us as a family. He checked with his 2 daughters. They said they thought it was a good move, and he said, you know what, I even love my son even more after being able to join him in his coaching ways here and to try to get the Raiders righting the ship, which they have so far. Yeah, you know, it's interesting. You don't know who's the head coach there if you really weren't aware. Watch the reaction moments ago.
He is one of the most intense people that I've been around. Really a great family, great story right there. And why wouldn't you want somebody like his dad on the bench with all the basketball knowledge? Obviously was coached alongside Rick Pitino back in when he was in Providence. So
you weren't afraid of Bill back in the day, were you?
Oh, man, I didn't want anything to do with him whatsoever, man. I wanted to stay away from him.
Seems awful friendly now.
Class act. One of the scariest voices in college basketball.
Really?
Really an imposing presence, but I think really a great story right here. And I told him earlier, I said, I envy you. To be able to work with your father, son like that, I think it's a great experience, and obviously it's great for Wright State.
In many ways, it's helped Billy Donlin Jr. to calm down a bit, according to people around the program, and conversely has helped dad, who has gone through the death of his wife, Billy's mom, a couple years ago due to cancer.
Really a touching story. As you said, it just drew him closer to his son and family.
It remains 23-19 in favor of the Ramblers as we are under 5 minutes for the first half. Plenty at stake, particularly for Wright State, trying to stay undefeated and at the top spot of the conference. Offensive foul on the Raiders. Horizon preseason poll had Valparaiso as almost the unanimous pick. Titans second, then Green Bay, Youngstown State, and Cleveland State. Ramblers pick 7th and Wright State dead last. Billy Donlin said, I'm not angry about it. I don't agree with it, but I'm not angry about it.
Well, what does Loyola do? Open up at Valparaiso, and they knock him off. So that's the reason why preseason polls are exactly that, Jim. You never know what you're going to have. And both teams really are young. And, you know, you got a player like Cully Payne, who's a Bob Cousy candidate. And, you know, he hasn't played basketball in 2 years. So now he's starting to get back comfortable on the basketball court. And you have a completely different basketball team.
I won't tell you how I voted in the preseason poll, but I didn't pick the Raiders first. That much I can tell you.
I don't think you're alone in that category right there.
Cully Payne is double teamed. Tries to get out of trouble, hands off to Thomas, and somehow Thomas gets off a shot and he's got free throws coming up.
And that's the aspect that Cully Payne brings to this team. Loyola, last year they didn't have a guy that can break down the defense and find guys. Cully Payne does that. He's a guy that's quick enough, he's big enough where he can get in the lane and either create for himself or create for teammates, as he did on that last possession.
Two fouls now on Tavares Sledge, team foul number 8 on Wright State. Perfect in their free throw shooting to this point. 5 of 5 as Sledge sits out the remainder of the first half with those two fouls.
Coach Moser called him Thomas, one of the most improved players that he's had on his basketball team. Really likes his work ethic, and he just continued to get better as the season has gone along.
A pretty solid game against Mississippi State. 16 points, 6 rebounds, 25 minutes. Arsenault has been the offense for Wright State as he now is into double figures.
Jim, I think at some point they're going to have to think about doubling him when he comes off screens, because right now it's just too easy for him. He's getting in the lane and he's getting uncontested layups, or he's finding wide open jump shooters on the perimeter.
Arsenault with 10 points for the game, and that's traveling call on the Ramblers.
Early on, it's been Wright State and Arsenault with the floater in the lane. Well, with no answer for Arsenault.
Check this out.
What exactly am I looking at here?
We got a front door cam, bedroom cam, closet cam, cam cam.
Cam cam?
Yep, with all this fresh new Under Armour gear from Foot Locker, you know, I decided to beef up security.
What's that one?
That's the Steve cam. I don't trust you.
I'm out of here.
Stay on him, Jerry.
Dumbest thing ever.
I still see you.
Discover card.
I asked my husband to pay our bill, and he forgot.
Yeah, I've got one like that too,
but you have the new IT card, and it's your first time making a payment, so there's no late fee. Really?
Yep. You don't even have to ask.
And we'll never raise your APR for paying late either.
Oh, that's great. So?
Is your husband off the hook?
No.
He went out for milk last week and came back with a puppy.
Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Well,
forgiveness is a wonderful thing. Yeah.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
This season's been exciting, with thrills at every turn. The fans have been rewarded with free pizzas they have earned. But winning isn't over. Super Bowl will be the best. With Papa John's and Peyton, just wait to see what's next.
As the official pizza sponsor of Super Bowl 47, Papa John's offers you a large one-topping pizza for only $10. Or choose any large, just $2 more. Order now at papajohns.com.
Better ingredients,
better pizza.
Papa John's.
3:41 remains in the first half. Ramblers 24, Raiders 21, and Reggie Arsenault, the one-man attack so far for Wright State.
He's been impressive on the offensive end, knocking down jump shots, creating offense for other players, and right here showing off the floater and the lane. Loyola's going to have to do a better job on Arsenault.
Jim Barber, Malcolm Huckabee, started Boston College. Welcome to our special night of Loyola basketball. First, we started with the Greyhounds and their win over Fairfield. Now we got the Ramblers and their version of Loyola tonight here from Chicago. And what's expected to be a defensive-minded game, should we anticipate these two teams clamping down as we go along?
Well, of course, that always happens. Just like you say, a guy's a great free throw shooter. He steps up and he doesn't make a free throw. Same here. We thought this was going to be a defensive battle, and now it's turned into an offensive game for both teams. And I think they will settle down, though, Jim, as they get deep in to this game, obviously 3:41 to go in the first half.
Well, let's see if your suggestion of how to defend Arsenault is going to take place here, because he is scoring at will. Unforced error picked up by Averkamp to Joe Crispin. Six, Wright State turnover for the game. The Ramblers at 10-5, were just 7-23 last year. Already have played well against Michigan State before losing at the Breslin Center in East Lansing. Defeated Mississippi State for the SEC. And minus a poor showing against Green Bay, but really had a pretty good year to this point. Packer inside, recognize it, finds a shooter. Good ball movement, no points though for Wright State.
Yeah, and that's been the story of the first half for Wright State, with the exception of Reggie Arsenault. They have not been able to knock down some wide open looks.
It's a blocking foul coming up on the Raiders, and certainly unwarranted, because at this point, majority of the fouls in Wright State's category, and that's already number two on Cole Darling. They'll go along with two from Tavares Sledge, one of the other starters, and those two guys make up the front line for Wright State.
Jim, here's the problem right now with Wright State. They're shooting 18% from the three-point line, 2 of 11, and they've been good looks. They have not been forced threes. They really have had some quality looks. It's just their inability to knock down shots.
First point of the game for Cully Payne. Iowa transfer who sat out last year. Comes off a game recently in which he scored 24 points in the win over DePaul on the other side of Chicago.
And it's so tough, man. He hasn't really played basketball in over close to 2 years. And, you know, the first couple of games, he was just trying to feel his way out on the court. And you can see his confidence is growing and he's getting more comfortable on the court.
That one blocked by Nick Osborne.
Osborne doing a great job. He gave up baseline, but recovered and came up with the block right there. And I think he's got to give him a little bit of space on that right there. He'd be fortunate to come up with a block right there, but you don't want to body up with guys and not be able to cut off baseline.
Yeah, when you go baseline, there's that invisible defender, that sixth defender that a defense suddenly has. Wright State finding difficulty in finding someone else to score besides Arsenault.
That's been problematic for them, I think, Jim, as they get deeper into Horizon League play. You can't just depend on your defense and one person to score for you on the offensive end. You're going to need a consistent effort from four other guys out on the court.
Christian Thomas picked up the foul moments ago, and now we got some pushing and shoving between A.J. Packer and Nick Osborne inside. Jerry Pollard will square that away. You also see Mike Bray in the middle of it.
This is what we expected in this basketball game. Both teams get after you on the defensive end, and you're going to have more scrums like that out on the court with two great defensive teams.
1-2 in the Horizon League as Matt Vest drives to the basket. Another foul called on the Ramblers. Coming up on ESPNU as this conference swings into a 16-game this season and 16-game schedule and culminates with a tournament in March. Valparaiso and Detroit could be a matchup of first-place teams as we get to January 17th. On the 25th, Green Bay and Milwaukee. That's an on-campus site this year for Milwaukee, so that should be a wild atmosphere. Well, you probably know the two coaches from Youngstown State and Detroit got together at midcourt last night. It wasn't pleasant. We'll have a rematch for you Friday, February 1st.
Anytime you lose double digits like that, obviously, coach is not going to be happy. I think, you know, sometimes people will think, hey, maybe you don't need to run it up like that, but they'll have their chance to get back out.
From Cully Payne, Ben Averkamp scores. Ramblers by five, and that's nine now for Averkamp. With 18 points and 8 rebounds, and one of the few players that had something promising the other night. JT Yoho is a good three-point shooter. Misses there. The Wright State Raiders' troubles continue with the outside shot. Payne, tough drive to the goal. Thomas. Not an assist, is it?
Thomas is doing a great job. I don't think he gets an assist for that one right there, but Thomas doing a great job on the offensive glass.
Ramblers' largest lead of the game, and this is a run of 13-6. Ramblers will use a timeout as opposed to lose it at the end of the first half with 1:06 remaining. Three-point shooting this year, we're seeing some of those stars on display tonight. In fact, three of the four. JT Yoho, Wright State at 45%. Devin Turk at 45%. And Cole Darling, who's picked up two early fouls at 43%. I'm going to go back to a question earlier. Wright State had some success with Reggie Arsenault knocking down two threes. Even though the looks are good, too much reliance on the three ball?
Yeah, I think in the last, I'd say, 3-4 minutes, they've been settling for contested threes. And when you miss as many as they have, 11 straight threes, I think it's maybe time for you to rethink that philosophy and try to make it easy for yourself and try to drive the basketball to the rim.
Payne and Turk in the backcourt. Let's see what Porter Moser, the Rambler coach, drew up after the timeout. Looking for Averkamp, can't get it to him yet. On Devin Turk on the baseline. Fifteen to shoot. Averkamp backing his way in and firing to Jeff White. Averkamp drew the defense. White got the good look out of it.
And Jen, that's an unselfish play that time by Averkamp. He draws so much attention, instead of forcing up his shot, kicks it out to a wide-open teammate who knocked down the three.
Last 90 seconds, Ramblers on a 7-0 run. Ten seconds left. Arsenault lost the ball. Tries to get it back. Out of bounds to Wright State, 3.3 remaining. Coming up the half, a preview of ESPNU's Saturday lineup. A look at number one Duke as it features a dangerous game at NC State in Raleigh on Saturday, and highlights and stats from a game that started off from a defensive standpoint, but lately the offense has picked up nicely for the Ramblers, who have taken a 17-17 tie and parlayed that into a 10-point lead.
Well, again, really a good job, Jim. Not settling for jumpers, getting some stops on the defensive end. They've gotten some easy transition buckets, and then on the last couple of possessions, Ben Averkamp, I can't say enough about how impressed I am with his basketball game. He's a focal point of the offense, and he's being unselfish with the basketball, creating easy opportunities for his teammates.
Seems, too, that a team that needs to win the most, the team that feels the most desperate, which is Loyola, after a 12-point first-half performance at Green Bay and subsequent loss. Usually when that team needs to get a win, it comes out and plays like it needs to get a win.
I think they got the message on that bus ride home from Coach Moser where they weren't going to come out and have another 12-point first-half performance.
Final seconds, first half. Packer for three. Wright State Raiders undefeated in the conference at 3-0, but they're not playing like a co-leader. Just shooting 32% from the floor, and Ben Averkamp leading the Ramblers to a 10-point lead at 33-23. Lots to talk about the break. Come back with us here in Chicago. We'll be right back.
Here's to being one of one. A true one of a kind.
This year, make safety your top priority and save hundreds with our best offer. Get an ADT security system starting at just $49 installed, but for a limited time only. That's an instant savings of $250. Don't leave your family's safety to chance when you can take advantage of these savings now. Call or visit ADT.com/TV.
I had a break-in. By the time we called the police, there wasn't much they could do. I felt so helpless.
ADT quickly called the police. I felt like it was over right away.
Feels like it's still not over. We lost our digital photos, financial records, things that insurance simply can't replace.
Protect yourself with the fast alarm response of ADT. With 24/7 monitoring against burglary, fire, and high levels of carbon monoxide, starting at just over $1 a day. And now, get installation starting at just $49, a savings of $250. But hurry, these savings end soon.
I'm glad we had ADT.
ADT. Always.
Maybe, like a lot of people across America, you've been hit by credit card bills, a divorce, or you lost your job. Now the feeling of debt is overwhelming, but we believe everyone deserves a second chance. We're the providers of Care One Debt Relief Services, created by Bernie Dansel on this very idea of second chances after he overcame his own battle with debt. Call our certified personal finance counselors for your free customized plan and start to see your savings in minutes. It's not a loan. It's not bankruptcy. It's debt consolidation with a payment you can afford. We've helped over 5 million people, and as the nation's largest brand of debt relief, we stand by our service with a 6-month money-back guarantee, so there's no risk to you. Care One helps good people get a second chance. So call us right now for your free customized plan at 1-855-66-HELPS or visit careonehelps.com. Care One. We're in the business of second chances.
We are at halftime. I'm Matt Schick, along with former North Carolina and Notre Dame head coach Matt Doherty. Some good games coming up tomorrow on ESPNU, beginning at noon Eastern, right here on the U with Marquette and Pittsburgh, as Marquette takes the trip to Pennsylvania. And this is a Marquette team 2-0 in league. Pittsburgh coming off a nice win against Georgetown.
Well, Pittsburgh leads the Big East in scoring defense, and on the road, Marquette struggles to score. I give the edge to Pittsburgh in this battle.
Marquette has struggled big time, and it's only two road games this season, failing to score 50 points in either game. Pittsburgh, the Big East top scoring defense, holding opponents to just under 53 points a game. They held Georgetown to under 50 in that win. Numbers you need to know for Texas at Iowa State. For Texas, it's 38. The Longhorns' field goal percentage since December 4th. Among schools from the Power Six conferences, only West Virginia is worse. On the other hand, Iowa State's number to know, 82.5. That's the Cyclones' scoring average. That's tops in the Big 12. They scored 89 in their loss to Kansas. Also on ESPNU, 4 o'clock Eastern tomorrow, Florida taking on LSU, a Florida team that has won 3 straight.
Well, Florida is very potent. They scored 27 points off of 19 turnovers committed by Georgia, 17 assists in that game.
Yeah, since dropping a couple of games to Arizona and Kansas State, Florida coming around trying to extend the win streak over LSU to 4 straight tomorrow in Baton Rouge on the U. Strangely, though, LSU has won 3 of its last 4 at home against the Gators. Tigers trying to avoid their first 0-2 start in SEC play since the 2009-2010 season. Obviously, Coach Donovan, he's got something nice going there in Florida. He's won national championships. What about this season? What are they doing so well? What's key?
Well, I think they're really sharing the basketball. They had 17 assists against Georgia. Billy was quoted after the game talking about, we want to play the right way. And if you look here, count the number of passes that they make, changing the sides of the floor multiple times. That's the second side of the floor. Now it goes to the third side of the floor. You see the blue line down the middle of the court. The defense then breaks down. They sprint out to a pick and roll. They find seams. The defender helps up. You see Young hiding on the baseline, great bounce pass for a high percentage shot.
When you look at Florida as they take on LSU, in the grand scheme of things in the SEC, are they the best team top to bottom in the SEC?
Right now, I think the two best teams in the SEC are Florida and Missouri. I think those teams are deep. They have terrific guard play. Kenny Boynton is kind of out of his slump right now. Florida's dangerous from the three-point line. They basically are leading the league 1, 2, or 3 in all the critical stats, from field goal percentage to field goal percentage defense, rebounding down the line. Missouri with Phil Pressey, and when Bowers gets healthy, they're right there too.
All right, so that's at 4 Eastern on ESPNU. Also tomorrow, right after that, 6 Eastern on the U. St. Louis taking on Temple. St. Louis trying to snap a 6-game losing streak to the Owls. However, St. Louis has won 9 straight.
Give Jim Crews the job for good.
Numbers you need to know. How about Arizona at Oregon State on ESPNU Saturday night, tomorrow night, 8 Eastern. Arizona's number 2006, which stands for the year in which the Wildcats last got swept on the road at the two Oregon schools. They lost to Oregon last night. For the Beavers, their number is 3. That's how many wins they have over the Wildcats in their last 15 meetings. When it comes to Sean Miller's club, it's obviously built a nice power there with the Wildcats. Only one loss on the season, that coming against Oregon. What has been working for Sean Miller and the Cats?
Well, I think the biggest thing is his defense, the pack line defense. They have pressure on the ball, but the other four players are going to stay inside basically a 17-foot imaginary circle inside the three-point line. They're going to be in position to help on dribble penetration or any penetrating pass, as you see Mark Lyons and Nick Johnson in position for the steal. Gives you an opportunity to score in transition against an unset defense.
So an Arizona team that was out to an 11-0 lead in that game.
And then their half-court execution. Great back screen, no help, no pressure on the basketball. Gives an opportunity for Nick Johnson to find Mark Lyons for an easy shot.
There is that 11-point lead they had. They blew it late. Oregon and Coach Dane Altman comes out and gets that one. So they're in action again tomorrow night, 8 Eastern on ESPNU. So here is your slate on Saturday. It all begins tomorrow, Marquette and Pittsburgh. Marquette at Buzz Williams. They're riding high right now. Texas, Iowa State, Florida, LSU, followed by an A-10 matchup. And then we finish with the Pac-12.
Want to know what I did in the last 5 hours? I played a round of golf. And then I read a book while teaching myself how to play guitar.
Ran 10 miles while knitting myself a sweater. Jumped out of a plane.
Finally, I became a ping pong master.
While recording
my debut album.
How, you ask? With 5-hour energy. I get hours of energy now, no crash later. Wait to see the next 5 hours.
Capital One Cash Rewards Card gives you 1% cash back on all purchases, plus a 50% annual bonus. And everyone but her likes 50% more cash. But I have an idea.
Do you want a princess dress?
Yeah.
Cupcakes?
Yeah.
Do you want an Etch-a-Sketch?
Yeah.
Do you want 50% more cash?
No.
You got talent.
The Capital One Cash Rewards Card gives you 1% cash back on every purchase, plus a 50% annual bonus on the cash you earn. It's the card for people who like more cash.
But you want it.
I usually say that.
People really love Snapshot from Progressive. But don't just listen to me. Listen to these happy Progressive customers.
I plugged in Snapshot, and 30 days later, I was saving big on car insurance.
With Snapshot, I knew what I could save before I switched to Progressive.
The better I drive, the more I save.
I wish our company had something this cool.
Yeah.
You're not filming this, are you?
Aw, camera shy. Snapshot from Progressive.
Test drive Snapshot before you switch. Visit Progressive.com today.
Recognized as one of Ohio's leading universities, Wright State offers a welcoming environment to nearly 20,000 students from all backgrounds, from all 50 states, and from 64 countries, with a dedication to service. Students pursue degrees in demand, such as accountancy, and are well on their way to successful careers, winning a national accounting competition an unprecedented 5 times. Our focus on ingenuity has made us one of Ohio's top research universities. We've developed a meaningful partnership to improve the diagnosis and treatment of neurological disorders, and a one-of-a-kind training facility for healthcare providers and disaster responders from around the world, one of our 6 Ohio Centers of Excellence. Our culture of creativity has made us a trailblazer for collaboration and innovation in the arts. Built on a heritage of innovation, Wright State University's positive impact is felt throughout our region and the world.
He's had a great big time year. He's a prime time performer.
And an exclamation point for Mason Plumlee.
He now knows he's a star.
ESPN's Journey to the Tourney is a season-long spotlight on games that will impact the tournament. And our journey continues tomorrow with a matchup of top ACC contenders. As that man, seen moments ago, Mason Plumlee, leads the Blue Devils against C.J. Leslie and the Wolfpack. ESPN's Journey to Tourney, number one Duke against number 20 NC State. Malcolm, take a look at the numbers, and are you surprised by what he's been able to do to opponents night in and night out?
Not surprised at all, and what he's added to this Duke team is an inside presence. You know about the perimeter players, shooters like Curry on the perimeter, but he cleans up everything on the glass, and he's a big reason why Duke is number one.
Number one against number 20, that's tomorrow on the ESPN networks. We come back more of our Eisen League basketball coverage tonight from Chicago.
Ladies, why is your man watching this snoozer of a game? Because I'm on his fantasy football team. So he gets for 10 points if we win or not. Boom! It's a guy thing. Like Dr. Pepper 10. With all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper and just 10 manly calories, it's like a fantasy soda, but you can drink it.
Get in there, hot dog!
It's what guys want. Like scoring touchdowns with players that fake coaching.
Woo!
So close. So keep the reality TV and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10, it's not for women.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Oh, hello. Do you want to be amazing?
I hope so.
Here's some tips to get you started.
Don't do this. Do this instead. Don't do this. Do this.
You want a first-class ticket to amazing? You can get Gamefly. Gamefly offers over 8,000 video game titles with no late fees and free PC downloads.
Be amazing!
Get to Gamefly.com, click the joystick, and to school, and start your extended free trial today.
Honey, did you pay the lawn guy?
Now, small businesses don't have to chase down their customers to get paid. With Pay Anywhere, you can accept credit cards on any smartphone or tablet. There's no setup, monthly, or hidden fees. You're charged a low rate only when you process. If you're a small business, don't wait to get paid.
Where's my money?
Pay Anywhere, available at these fine retailers. Get paid now.
Buffalo were born to roam. It's what they do, like, all the time. And they're getting pretty good at it. Probably because when you're born to do something, it just comes naturally. Like how Esurance was born online to save people money on car insurance. Super efficient, saving people money is what they do, naturally. Yep, you'll get used to insurance for the modern world.
Out of here.
The Buffalo? Not so much. Esurance, now backed by Allstate. Click or call.
Ramblers close out the first half on a 7-0 run and lead at halftime, 33-23. Jim Barber, Malcolm Huckabee here on ESPN. You, Malcolm, former star, the Iron Man, by the way, at Boston College. Reggie Arsenault, 10 points for Wright State, 2 of 5, 3-point shooting. The rest of the team 0 for 10 with a 3-ball. Where's the offense going to come from in the second half for Wright State?
It's been the story of the first half, but Wright State had some really quality looks. They were 2 of 15 from the three-point line in the first half, and a lot of times when you have a number like that, 2 of 15, you would think they were bad looks. Not so the case in this game right here. Wright State, you're going to see it right here, freeze it. Two defenders drawn. Good play by a Wright State post player finding a wide-open shooter on the perimeter, and coaches will live with that look any day of the week right there, a wide-open, uncontested three, but you got to knock those down.
Let's take a look at the first half numbers, which Billy Donlin could not be pleased with, as his team, which usually shoots three-pointers with some accuracy, is down in the dumps, 32% overall for the Raiders against 46 for Loyola, a 20-14 edge on the boards, and the bench points, a significant number, 15-4 in favor of the Ramblers. Now, if the Ramblers and you are stacking in that defense and you're daring Wright State to shoot from the outside, should the Raiders take some shots?
Well, if you shoot 13% as they did in the first half, they're going to need to continue to do that right there, Jim, and get to the hole. That's what you want to do if you're Wright State. And if you're Loyola, you want to continue to make them shoot threes. You don't want to give them uncontested layups as they just did on the opening half.
You could tell it was a halftime conversation between coach and players because Griffin had an open three on that baseline and elected to take it to the rim.
And rightfully so. At 13%, I'm sure any coach would tell players, I don't want anybody shooting threes until you try to get an easy bucket in the lane.
5 on the shot clock on this possession, the opening possession of the second half for the Ramblers. Payne was able to hit the rim, and somehow the Ramblers get the ball back. Jordan Hicks on a drive and a goal. Sometimes it's better to be, as the cliche goes, lucky than good.
Well, they got a break that time. They came up with an offensive rebound, and on that play, Wright State did everything right on that first possession except get the rebound.
I like, though, the way Wright State is thinking for the second half, traveling on sledge there, but again, trying to go inside, trying to attack the rim.
Well, they're trying to get back into this basketball game, and a lot of times coaches talk about the first 5 minutes of the first half and equally the first 5 minutes of the second half. Obviously, this is going to be crucial for Wright State to get back into this basketball game.
Part of the plan for Wright State, limit number one, Cully Payne in his assists. He has 2 this evening. Averkamp trying to assist Chrisman on the jumper. And it's picked up by 24 Matt Vest of the Raiders. Wright State starts tonight in first place with the Detroit Titans at 3-0. Darling off balance shot, can't get it to go. Vest tapped the rebound into the hands of the Raiders. And look how Wright State is looking to drive the ball here in the second half as opposed to shoot from the outside. Though deflected by Hicks and stolen by Jordan Hicks. Here's Payne on the flash to the goal and a foul called. Cully Payne, the Iowa transfer.
And Payne really doing a nice job, Jim, in pick and roll situations. Showed a little ball fake right there on this last play. We're going to see it right here. I love Rajon Rondo, and he's going to get to the free throw line. And in that first possession, I thought it was an interesting call by Wright State to go to zone, in particular when Loyola shot 57% from the three-point line in that first half.
Cully Payne from Schaumburg, Illinois, started his college basketball career with the Iowa Hawkeyes and Todd Licklider. In his second season, suffered a hernia injury that put him on the shelf. Licklider eventually was fired. And Payne has brought his college basketball talents to Chicago. And he is Porter Moser's kind of guy, don't you think?
He is, and he's the guy that really brings a different dimension to their ball club. Speaking with Coach Moser before the game, he said, look, we didn't have a guy when the shot clock was winding down or in the last situation right there, a pick and roll guy that can get in the lane and create his own shot or create for others. And he brings that to this basketball club.
And if you know the history of Cully Payne, he committed to DePaul when he was in eighth grade, which became a national story at the time. Now, eighth grade is what? That's old now, isn't it, for commits?
It's unbelievable. I mean, I can't imagine really understanding where you want to go, let alone high school, college, committing at an early age. But obviously, as you said, that's not too uncommon right now.
Well, he had the right city. He just winds up in Chicago with Loyola, and he lit up DePaul recently with 24. Reggie Arsenault has not stopped shooting and has not stopped scoring. He now has 13 for the game, 13 of his team's 28. It's almost half of the offense. And finally, a made three after 12 consecutive misses by the Raiders. They just need the right guy to shoot him. 36 for Loyola, 28 for Wright State. Christian Thomas taking his man off the dribble.
He's been impressive in this basketball game. Showed great strength right there. Gathered himself, went up and finished. He's been impressive for Loyola.
Second attempt at three of the second half is buried by Cole Darling. So the Raiders came out, drove the ball to the basket on several possessions to start the second half. And now when they're shooting the three ball, far more efficient than they were in the first half. Good backdoor attempt there, but the ball is kicked on the attempted pass to Crisman.
And you're gonna see right here, this is a nice ball screen, pick out, and you always tell young players, Jim, I always tell young players, if you wanna get open for a three-point shot, go set a screen. That time, you set a screen, the defense is forced to help, and you're wide open on the perimeter.
Four made threes in the game for the Raiders. Payne missing on the three, but another offensive rebound for the Ramblers, who have done a good job attacking the offensive glass. Thomas on the cut to the basket, call for an offensive foul. That's number three now, Christian Thomas.
One of the few mistakes you're going to see right here from Thomas, who's played a really good basketball game for Loyola in the first half, and that's a good charge that time by Wright State stepping up, and those are the little things that count up, add up to try to get back into a basketball game.
So 19-year-old Matt O'Leary in the game for Christian Thomas, who has three fouls and goes to the bench. Raiders have climbed within seven. Top two defensive teams in the Horizon League at each other this evening. O'Leary Aberkamp before he can score the ball. Personal foul call on Jaron Young. 15:53 remains. Will Wright State stay undefeated in the Horizon League?
Cat's Corner debuts Tuesday at 4:30 on ESPNU.
Recognized as one of Ohio's leading universities, Wright State offers a welcoming environment to nearly 20,000 students from all backgrounds, from all 50 states, and from 64 countries, with a dedication to service. Students pursue degrees in demand, such as accountancy, and are well on their way to successful careers, winning a national accounting competition an unprecedented five times. Our focus on ingenuity has made us one of Ohio's top research universities. We've developed a meaningful partnership to improve the diagnosis and treatment of neurological disorders, and a one-of-a-kind training facility for healthcare providers and disaster responders from around the world, one of our six Ohio Centers of Excellence. Our culture of creativity has made us a trailblazer for collaboration and innovation in the arts. Built on a heritage of innovation, Wright State University's positive impact is felt throughout our region and the world.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you 1% cash back on all purchases, plus a 50% annual bonus, and everyone likes 50% more.
Jenner! Yeah!
50% more.
You know what I mean?
50% more flash.
50% more taters. That's where tops come from.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you 1% cash back on every purchase, plus a 50% annual bonus on the cash you earn. It's the card for people who like more cash.
50% more spy stuff. What's in your wallet?
This card's too small.
Welcome back to Chicago, the home of the Loyola Ramblers. Loyola leading Wright State 38-31. We're just a shade into the second half. Let's take a look at the Ramblers back on December 29th. Across town against DePaul. Only Payne with 24 in the game to lead Loyola, and Christian Thomas had 12 points and 10 rebounds as the Ramblers get their first win over DePaul in almost a quarter of a century. Only the second victory for Loyola in DePaul's home court in 21 games, and that ended the Blue Demon's seven-game winning streak Final score 69-61 as the Ramblers beat a team in the Power Six, the Big East Conference.
Jim, that's a big win for Loyola. And a big reason for that win is Cully Payne, who we're going to take a look. He's going to get a breather right now, and he was huge for them in that basketball game.
Well, if only he had held to his commitment back in eighth grade to go to DePaul, that never would happen, right?
I'm still amazed at how eighth grade.
Jordan Hicks inside position to score and give the team a 9-point lead.
And Jim, what's happening with Loyola on the offensive end? They're getting great post position. Wright State's got to do a better job of pushing post players away from the hoop. They're just giving them uncontested layups with really little resistance on these last couple of possessions.
Does it feel to you the Ramblers are the more physical team today?
Absolutely. And we're going to see here Arsenault with another find. And I've been so impressed with his game, not only scoring the basketball, but Reggie Arsenault's doing a great job setting up his teammate. He should probably have double digits assist in this basketball game if they continue to knock down shots like this.
Cole Darling's a good three-point shooter for the Raiders. He has hit two in the second half. And it's brought Wright State back within six at 40-34. Joe Bramante, backup point guard in the game, along with Reggie Arsenault. So, got two guys who can play the point. Ball lost and picked up by Hicks. Both teams with extensive workouts today. Ramblers, about 90 minutes, almost the same for Wright State. Haverkamp gets the matchup he wants, but unable to convert the hook. Another chance for Wright State to draw closer. All things considered, as badly as the Raiders shot from the three-point area in the first half, they're right there.
I think any coach can take that. You shoot 13% from the three-point line in the first half, and you're down six.
And they have made their last three attempts here in the second half. Yoho on the drive, a little too strong. O'Leary taps it to himself, and it remains the Ramblers by six. Oil in the home white, the visiting green, the dark uniforms belong to Wright State, which is on the bus when this game is over, back to Dayton. Not expected to get home until early morning, around six. Here's White, little fake, leaves it short. Here's the third opportunity for the Raiders to draw closer. Arsenault on the baseline, and Reggie Arsenault stepping to the free throw line. One of the top teams in the nation. Highlight ESPNU's Pac-12 showdown tomorrow night. Mark Lyons, the Xavier transfer, leads the Wildcats of Arizona against Roberto Nelson and the Beavers. Arizona suffering that upset loss in Eugene last night to Oregon. Visiting Oregon State Saturday night on ESPNU and also live on Watch ESPN. Wildcats still the cream of the Pac-12. And in fact, they've got a buzz going back in Tucson. They say it's comparable to the days of head coach Lute Olson.
I'm really doing a fine job with that program. I actually played against them back when he was at Pitt. Back in my old Boston College days, a really heady point guard, Sean Miller, and obviously having a lot of success in Arizona.
What do you make of this run by the Raiders, which has drawn them within four?
Well, I think it started, obviously, on the defensive end. They've gotten some stops, and then early in the second half, they've been able to knock down some of those threes that were really open looks. So I think if they can continue to knock down some open looks, and Arsenault's been impressive, he's going to get a rest right now. I think, obviously, they have a chance to win this basketball game.
Not a lot of movement by the Ramblers, so the shot clock is at 15, and not much is happening. Payne will try to change that as he goes through a double team. And with 9 seconds remaining, the Ramblers keep the ball, but this is possession in which Loyola is not getting much to happen.
And you expect that from a good defensive team. You see this right here. Wright State cuts off the baseline and making it tough for Payne to get in. That's a good defensive rotation by Wright State.
Turk called for traveling. So it's 7 minutes gone by in the second half. Wright State, once down by 11, is now within four and on the 11-4 run.
Jim, we talked about maybe 56 is that magical number where the first one to 56 wins, and I think we might be right.
Yeah.
I think we might be right. 12:58 to go in this basketball game is 40-36, and with the way that both teams play defense, I think points are going to be really difficult to come by as we get later in this second half.
The 56-point mark that Malcolm refers to, the benchmark for this game, is based on the fact that neither team allows more than 55 points a game to anybody. And Wright State has given up 60 points or better just three times all year. Raiders with the ball down by four. Trying to hang on to first place, but now they turn it over to Cully Payne. Payne is in trouble. Call for traveling. Porter Moser said he got bumped. Head coach of the Ramblers pleading to Rick Hartzell, who says, hey, that wasn't my call.
I think it was the right call, though, by the referees in that situation. Both point guards, Arsenault the first time for Wright State, got a little out of control. And that time, Cully Payne, I think a one-on-three fast break, you got to pull the basketball back out.
Ramblers have not scored in the last 3.5 minutes. Raiders at 3-0, Titans at 3-0. Those are the top two teams in the conference standing. Arsenault again, and Wright State runs down by 11 as pulled to within one. 18 for Reggie Arsenault. And in the second half, the Raiders have hit four.
And it's been the Reggie Arsenault show in the second half, putting Wright State on his shoulders.
This happy couple used Capital One Venture Miles for their destination wedding. Double miles you can actually use.
But with those single mile travel cards.
Blacked out, but I'm a bridesmaid.
X marks the spot she'll never sit.
But I bought a dress.
A toast.
To the Capital One Venture card. Fly any airline, any flight, anytime. Double miles you can actually use. What a coincidence.
What's in your wallet?
What I did in the last 5 hours? I played a round of golf. And then I read a book while teaching myself how to play guitar. Ran 10 miles while knitting myself a sweater. Jumped out of a plane. Finally, I became a ping pong master while recording my debut album. How, you ask? 5-hour energy. I get hours of energy now, no crash later. Wait to see the next 5 hours.
Raiders 2 for 15, shooting threes in the first half, not so in the second half, 4 of 4. Reggie Arsenault has been knocking him down, and so has Cole Darling, so they're getting the ball in the hands of the right guys to shoot it. And the Raiders have erased an 11-point deficit and cut it all the way to 1 here at 40-39. Billy Donlin's the head coach of the Raiders in his third year, and his dad, Bill Donlin Sr., has now joined him on the bench as director of basketball operations. Dad said he wasn't sure it was going to be the right move. Said, I want to do something that's good for Billy, but it has worked up far and beyond what he expected. He said, I love my son even more. And people close to this program said he has been a calming effect on his son because, according to his son, he has the ability to move on from something, let it go, and then allow everything to breathe a little bit and everybody to recollect themselves. And he thinks that effect may be something that the youngster, Billy Donlin, has been picking up.
What a great story. And obviously, a lot of basketball knowledge on that bench, but just a terrific story, Jim.
Haverkamp trying to reignite this Rambler offense. Turk can do just that. And the Raiders have a chance to get the lead. They made adjustments at the end of the first half. They attacked the goal more to start the second half. And that opened up the three-point shooting, which has become more effective. Yet on that possession, Raiders with a turnover. One-point game, and we go away for a while.
Shoot, I missed a payment.
Discover card.
I missed a payment.
Oh, shoot. Shoot, this is bad, isn't it?
Oh, no, we're good.
This is your first time missing a payment.
And you've got our new card, so we don't
charge you a late fee for that.
Plus, we won't hike up your APR for paying late either.
Man, that's great.
It is great, man.
Thank you.
Well, Thanks for your help.
Yeah, no problem. Call back anytime.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Late payment forgiveness. Get the new IT card at discover.com.
It's a Saturday afternoon doubleheader on ESPN. At noon, the undefeated Blue Devils head down to Paco Road to take on C.J. Leslie and the Wolfpack.
Let's make our statement.
Then at 2, sophomore star James Michael McAdoo leads North Carolina in a tough road contest against Florida State. Saturday Showcase. Duke, NC State at noon Eastern, and North Carolina, Florida State at 2, tomorrow on ESPN.
We love living out here. Fresh air, great neighbors, and now we have great internet with HughesNet Gen 4. We picked HughesNet because it's America's number one choice for satellite internet, and now it's better than ever.
I can keep up with all the sports action and dominate my fantasy league.
With download speeds up to 15 times faster, we can all do more with HughesNet Gen 4.
It's awesome for downloading songs and listening to music online.
It makes doing homework so much easier.
I'm finally getting into this whole social networking, and HughesNet Gen 4 definitely makes it easier. I just shared all our vacation pictures. Now we can live where we love and still stay connected. And you can too. Just get HughesNet Gen 4.
Sign up now for HughesNet Gen 4 and get speeds up to 15 megabits per second with improved download capacity. Plus, you'll get free standard installation. So call now. Call 1-800-274-9752 or visit HughesNet60.com and order today.
Loyola of Illinois 40, Wright State 39, 11:42 for the second half. Preseason poll as conducted by media. Selected Valparaiso, odds on favorite to win. Detroit picks second, Green Bay third, the Ramblers seventh, and Wright State ninth. But a win tonight by the Raiders would put them, Malcolm, at 4-0, 25% into the season.
And I think a lot of that has to do with the play of their point guard, Reggie Arsenault, really making it easy for the other players around him. And I think if you're Loyola, I think you might have to start thinking about trapping him on those high ball screens, get the ball out of his hands, and let somebody else do the work for Wright State.
Somebody has to score the ball for the Ramblers. You haven't made a field goal in a long period of time, as you saw by the graphic. Who's it going to be? A lot of side-to-side action. They're having difficulty attacking inside. Devin Turk, no open looks for him with five to shoot. A good defense by Wright State. Now two, Turk forces. Fired it! Wow!
And that's a tough break. If you're Wright State, you do everything right. You force them into a contested NBA three with the shot clock winding down, and Turk knocks it down. Sometimes good offense is better than good defense.
Freshman from Houston, Texas. Best for three. First miss from the three-pointers in the second half, but on the weak side, Cole Darling leads it up for Wright State. Here's Cully Payne. They want to limit his assists. Devin Turk, nice friendly roll, and then they call the mini microwave. Batting after the great Vinny Johnson, who started for the Pistons, starting to bring some instant offense, and the Ramblers need it the most.
And the name is fitting. He can heat up really quick, and that's two big buckets for Loyola.
Sledge missed an easy one inside. Let's take a look at Devin Turk again. Just a freshman out of Westbury Christian, that great high school power in the state of Texas.
And sometimes, Jim, that's what you need. When you have shot clock winding down, you need somebody to go make a play. And Turk is turning into that guy. A really athletic kid, and he's got a quick release on his jumper. The future is bright.
Is taking the Ramblers from a one-point lead to five at 46-41. Doesn't sound significant, but considering how difficult it was for the Ramblers to score in this five-minute stretch, it has played some importance. Halfway through second half, here's Aberkamp against Sledge, trying to draw his defense, and he scores over Sledge, who's had some five-minute plays in the first half.
Aberkamp showing off the low post move right there, and Coach Donald's going to get a timeout and regroup. And really, sometimes good offense just beats good defense, and Wright State's doing a good job on a defensive end. And And you're going to see Averkamp right here on this play, Jim, where it's just good offense against really good defense. You slide, you keep the guy in front of you, and he's got two defenders on him, and he hits a tough fadeaway jumper in the lane.
Ben Averkamp, biology major, 3.8 GPA, headed to med school. ESPNU Saturday Showcase features a trio of great games at noon. Unbeaten in the Big East, Marquette squares off against Troy Woodall and Pitt. At two, Sheldon McClellan leads Texas against Iowa State. And at four, Kenny Boynton and the Gators at 11-2 face LSU for the SEC. Saturday Showcase is presented by 5-Hour Energy. The coverage tips at noon on ESPNU and also live on Watch ESPN. Trey Woodall averaging 6 assists a game for the Panthers. They're a team that is 3rd in the country at assists at nearly 19. Here it is 48-41 Ramblers trying to give Wright State its first loss in conference play. Second half shooting much stronger for the Raiders, who got to be a little bit more selective on shooting the three than they were in the first half. Tough drive to the goal by Jaron Young. It's off the Raiders and out of bounds to the Ramblers.
Loyola is picking up on the defensive end, doing a great job getting guys in the lane, cutting off dribble penetration, and coming up with a big possession.
Young's been limited at 2 points. He is a junior college star after playing 2 years of JC ball, now in the Division I level. He'll turn 21 years of age on Christmas Day. Averkamp, double, nearly triple on the baseline, got it to Thomas. Arsenal on the move for Wright State. Able to keep the possession, and Wright State is able to keep the ball.
Arsenal did a great job to keep his feet right there and avoid a probably costly turnover.
Raiders, by the way, down to 2 timeouts. Loyola has 3 remaining. Good give and go. The sledge from Reggie Arsenault, and the Raiders needed that basket.
Big basket. And again, Jim, set up by Reggie Arsenault, doing it all for Wright State, scoring, setting up teammates. And he's a guy I think is probably one of the better point guards in the Horizon League.
Arsenault has a game-high 18, and Malcolm has got 3 assists. Averkamp way short, Thomas to clean it up. Nobody blocked him out.
Thomas has been all over the offensive glass for Loyola, getting them easy buckets, and that's a big one right there. Push the lead to 7.
You know, you spent a lot of energy coming back as the Raiders did, and suddenly after that comeback, brought them within 1. They find themselves down by 5 as Matt Vest able to score inside. Raiders' game plan in the second half, far different than the first, not settling for the 3, and instead going to the goal. Crispin had the shot, and Crispin scores. Joe Crispin, the sophomore from Munster, the role player for the basket with 7:21 to go. And Tamara
slowing off the mid-range game, putting Loyola up 7.
Everywhere you go, it seems like someone's offering another deal.
But a really good deal isn't just about what you pay. It's about what you get.
At Wendy's, we stand for quality in everything we make. Like our new Right Price, Right Size menu, featuring fresh ingredients and delicious choices no matter what your budget is. Dad believed in a great meal at a fair price, and it's what we still believe.
At Wendy's, we want you to like what you spend and love what you eat. That's Wendy's way.
What's better, bigger or smaller?
Bigger!
So which would you rather have, a big treehouse or a small treehouse?
If it's big enough, you can have a disco.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you not want a smaller treehouse?
Because it wouldn't be able to fit a flat-screen TV, and then the TV would be about this big, and you would have to hold the wire. In the position you would hold the wire, you wouldn't be able to see the TV.
That's a pain in the buns.
Yep.
It's not complicated. Bigger is better. And AT&T has the nation's largest 4G network.
Ladies, why is your man watching this snoozer of a game?
because I'm on his fantasy football team. So he gets for 10 points if we win or not. Boom! It's a guy thing. Like Dr. Pepper 10, with all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper and just 10 manly calories, it's like a fantasy soda, but you could drink it.
Get in there, hot dog!
It's what guys want. Like scoring touchdowns with players that fake coaching. Woo! So close. So keep the reality TV and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10, it's not for women.
Inside the Raiders huddle, which includes assistant coaches Chris Moore, Scott Woods, and Brendan Mullins, Jim Barber and Malcolm Huckabee of Boston College. Wright State in 2007 faced Butler. The Wright to get to the NCAA tournament. Number one versus number two seed, and this night belonged to the Raiders for a sellout house. The Raiders win 60-55, the Horizon League Championship, and moved on to the NCAA tournament. Wright State trying to move into sole possession of first place. And with a win tonight, would do just that over Detroit, which won last night and went to 3-0 in the league. If you win the regular season championship, you get home turf, home field advantage in a tournament. As the one seed, you get all the way to the semifinals where we have to play a game, so it's a double bye.
I think there's so much parity in this league, really, 1 through 9. You have to show up to play every night here, as Valparaiso found out in their home opener against Loyola, where if you don't come to play any given night in Horizon League, you're going to get a loss.
Ramblers went 5 minutes without a basket, then hit 5 of their last 7 with that free throw, extending the lead to 8 at 53-45. Arsenal's been the offensive attack, and at his charge to the goal, Rick Hartson spots a foul. And Reggie Arsenal, 67% shooter, goes back to the free throw line. Two fouls now on Jeff White, team foul number 4 on Loyola.
Speaking with Coach Donovan today in the shoot around, the thing with Arsenal's game, he's matured and he's doing all the little things on the court, making good decisions with the basketball. You know the quickness is there. You know his ability to score the basketball is there, but it's the decision-making, setting up his other teammates, for me, that's been really impressive in this basketball game.
Yes, what did Donlin say that Reggie's philosophy now is, if I score less and my teammates score more, we will win more.
That's so hard to get players to buy into, where it's not always about scoring points. It's about doing the other things, making your teammates better, and that's what Reggie Arsenal has done.
Well, and frankly, with his 20 points tonight, Malcolm, they've needed him to score the ball, because in the first half, he was the only one able to shoot the 3-ball, and for the most part, the only one to get to the basket. 7 minutes remain. Ramblers by 6 with the basketball, and that's the point guard, Cully Payne. But Thomas inside. Another foul on Tavares Sledge, and that's number 4 on him. Now, if you're Billy Donlin, do you leave him in a game?
Yeah, I think right now in this situation, 6:52 to go, really, I don't think there's much time. In particular with the way that both teams are defending right now, obviously you don't want them to pick up that 5th foul, but they're going to need him in the basketball game.
Ramblers shoot free throws at 73 percentile, and in this game, 10 of 12. A double-double tonight for Christian Thomas, 11 points and 10 rebounds. Back in for Wright State, Miles Dixon replacing Tavares Sledge, who actually will sit with those 4 fouls.
Well, Wright State, Jim, I think right now it's going to start with Arsenal breaking down the defense, try to get an easy bucket in the lane or dish out for wide open shooters.
Off the hands of Cully Payne with 25 to shoot.
I think part of the reason why you want Arsenal and the ball in his hands is they're spread out on the defensive end. Loyola is, let him go to work in the middle of the floor, force Loyola to help, and then you're going to have some wide open looks on the perimeter.
personal crossover and knocks down the three.
Or you can just step out of the way and let Arsenal go to work, and that seems to be working for Wright State right now. He has been impressive in this basketball game.
That was your second option, right? 23 points, Reggie Arsenal, a career best. Nearly half of the Wright State points, and the Raiders are within five. Ben Averkamp against the smaller Cole Darling. Missed it, and it's out of bounds to Wright State. So the Raiders back on a run now with six to go.
You're going to see one of, in my mind, the best point guards in the Horizon League showing off all of the offensive moves that he has. He's been able to shoot the ball from distance. He's been able to break down the defense and find other guys. He's been impressive in this basketball game, and he's shooting at a high percentage.
Well, you see the numbers too, Malcolm. 7 of 10 shooting. I mean, it's been a very efficient 23 points, and frankly, they have needed his offense. We talk about, in theory, wants to get others involved as Dixon scores there. But without Reggie Arsenault's offense tonight, the Raiders have no chance.
And we got a ball game right here. And we said first one to 56 we think is going to win. Right now, Loyola at 55, and they get 57. And Averkamp has been impressive. I think he's a guy, Jim, you're going to have to put in the mix for Horizon League Player of the Year. He's so impressive on the offensive end.
Yes, he is. He's one of three Ramblers in double figures tonight, too. Arsenal tries it again. Not this time. Not necessarily a good attempt there, and a rebound to Devin Turk. The Raiders their first loss in conference play. Cully Payne, his call for traveling. That's his fourth turnover of the night.
Jim, on the offensive end for Loyola, I think, why make it difficult for yourself? Go to Averkamp, play through him, let him do work either on the wing or in the post, and force Wright State to double. They really can't play him straight up, and I think that's your best offense if you're Loyola. And you can see Coach Porter Moser talking to his point guard right now.
Paying out for the moment. Here's Arsenault with a screen from Sledge from the free throw line. Got it! Reggie Arsenault, now a career best, 25, putting on a show today.
Wow, that's all I can say is wow. His game tonight has been impressive. Pull-up jumpers, showing the range, he's quick. You're going to see the crossover right here, and then the finish. And really, it's been all Reggie Arsenault in this basketball game for Wright State, in particular in the second half, keeping them in this game.
Arsenault has 15 second-half points.
And Jim, they've been good looks, too. And really, in that first half, he probably should have had 10 assists. I mean, he set guys up for some wide open looks on the perimeter that weren't falling for Wright State. And right now, he's brought them within 2 points, and he's been doing it on both ends, and he deserves a break.
And his coaching staff says he spends a lot of time studying tape, and it's by his own request. So the coaching general on the floor gets a break, and he has brought Wright State almost single-handedly back to within one score. Ramblers have been able to answer every run of Wright State. Let's see if they are able to do so here. They're looking for Averkamp. Darnley's got a body on him. Averkamp, right hook, got it.
Jim, I'm going to say it right now. Averkamp should touch the basketball on every offensive possession for Loyola. Move out of the way, let him go to work in the post, and force Wright State to double. If they don't, he's going to score every time.
Good point. Darling back the other way, scores as well. They got the matchup they wanted. This time it's Darling against Averkamp.
Darling said right back at you, Averkamp, I can do that too, but I still think in this situation right now, Loyola up two, Averkamp has got to be the guy.
White attacks the goal, missed it. Darling rebound, here come the Raiders. Down by two. A basket to tie and a three-pointer for the lead. Vermonte runs the offense right now for the Raiders. Reggie Arsenal will check in at the next whistle. 13 on this possession remains. Dixon off balance, missed it, and a rebound to Averkamp. That would have tied it.
And not a bad look that time by Dixon. He's been quiet in the second half. Got his feet set, that ball was in and out.
Looking for Thomas down low. Instead, Averkamp drives the ball and is fouled by Cole Darling.
It's been Averkamp in the second half for Loyola, showing off the offensive post moves.
I'm Snow, and just like you, the further in the winter we go, the heavier I get. And while your pants struggle to support the heavier you, your roof struggles to support the heavier me. And your cut rate insurance might not pay for this. So get Allstate. You can save money and be better protected from mayhem. Like me.
Mayhem is everywhere. So get an Allstate agent. Are you in good hands?
The boys use Capital One Venture Miles for their annual football trip. That's double miles you can actually use. Tragically, their buddy got sacked by blackouts.
But it's our tradition.
That's roughing the card holder. But with the Capital One Venture card, you get double miles you can actually use. Ready, fright? Anytime.
The scoreboard doesn't lie.
What's in your wallet? I have me on my fantasy team.
Ladies, why is your man watching this snoozer of a game? Because I'm on his fantasy football team. So he gets pretend points if we win or not. Boom! It's a guy thing. Like Dr. Pepper 10. With all 23 flavors of Dr. Pepper and just 10 manly calories, it's like a fantasy soda, but you could drink it.
Get in there, hot dog!
It's what guys want. Like scoring touchdowns with players that fake coaching.
Woo!
So close. So keep the reality TV and lady drinks. We're good.
Dr. Pepper 10. It's not for women.
Loyola 59, Wright State 57. Another thriller tonight on ESPNU. This time in the Horizon League. Wright State started play tonight, tied with Detroit, so much at stake for the Raiders. The Ramblers try to move up to the fourth spot with a win this evening. Jim Barber, Malcolm Huckabee, who starred at Boston College. Take us through the last 3 minutes. What's important for Wright State? What matters for Loyola?
Well, for Loyola, I think you need to continue to go to Ben Averkamp. He's been the guy for you on the offensive end. They really have had no answer for him at his Wright State in the post, so you need to continue to go to him. And then I think for Wright State, it's going to be Reggie Arsenault. He's been impressive in this basketball game. Both those guys for the respective teams to touch the ball on every offensive possession.
Three timeouts remaining for the Ramblers, two for Wright State, and the fouls are even at five with a possession arrow favoring Loyola. Let's update our one-on-one. When we started tonight, we were talking point guards. In your assessment, how's each done?
Well, Reggie Arsenault has been impressive. He's been the one guy for Wright State that has carried them. And then I think Cully Payne, he needs to settle down and get Averkamp the basketball late in this basketball game. I think that's the job of the point guard. Recognize what's working for you, and they need to get the ball in Ben Averkamp's hand.
Averkamp matched up against Sledge, who has four fouls. Payne for three. Wright State with a rebound. Reggie Arsenault was on the bench resting for 3 minutes. Now he's in the game and with the ball. Raiders go inside. Cole Darling for the tie.
Darling has been dealing with shoulder problems, and it looks like he popped it out right there on that situation. He's in a lot of pain, but he's given Wright State some quality offense in the post.
Darling missed a number of games around the Christmas break due to the shoulder problem. He plays with a brace, and sometimes that brace needs to be tweaked.
And he's played big for them in the second half, Jim. That's a nice post move right there off of a little cross screen, and he comes across wide open, and he finishes. And you know, speaking with the coaching staff, they really like his toughness because he's been a guy that's been playing through a lot of pain.
ESPN College. anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at WatchESPN.com and with the WatchESPN app. Good to have you tonight on the U. Earlier tonight, Fairfield and Loyola Maryland came down to the final seconds before the Greyhounds won game two. Wright State, another Loyola, this time from Chicago, in a dead even match with 2:13 left. Each team has two timeouts remaining. Each team far from the bonus with five personal fouls and the possession arrow in favor of Loyola in case of a held ball. Cole Darling back in with the shoulder exposed. Thomas from the free throw line. Let's see if they try to find Darling, who in the first half failed to score but has 12 points in the second half. And Wright State will use one of its two remaining timeouts.
30-second timeout. Ball's
going to
go right here.
Again, Coach Porter Moser for Loyola has done a great job in coming out of timeouts, getting set plays, and getting high-percentage shots for his offense. That time, Thomas came off a screen, nice little down screen, and knocked down a nice little elbow jumper.
Reggie Arsenault averages 30 minutes a game. He's right at that number this evening. But it's his scoring that's been most effective. He has a career best, 25 tonight.
He's got a nice looking stroke. You're going to see the range right here. The ability to assist, which has been equally as impressive. And then the one-on-one crossover move. He's been on fire tonight for Wright State.
It has been Arsenault and Darling with the principal scoring for Wright State in the second half. In fact, they have 26. The team's 36 points. Reggie is well above his average this evening.
I think he is going to be a guy that's going to be in a discussion for a first-team all-league guy, certainly a second-team all-league guy if he continues to play like this.
Raiders with the ball down by two. Look to trap Arsenal for the moment, but then back off. Pass deflected. Out of bounds to the Raiders with 15 seconds remaining on the possession.
Jim, I don't like that possession. I like let Arsenal go to work at the top of the key. Everybody else clear out, run some type of high ball screen for him and let him get in the lane and then play off of him, either dribble, penetrate for a layup or a dribble drive or a kick.
Seven to shoot it. Arsenal now down to five. He'll fire a three. Got it again. Wright State goes up one with 90 seconds left. Here's Jeff White. And the Ramblers, with two timeouts remaining, will use one of them. It's the first Wright State lead since 14-11 in the first half.
And that's the reason why I like the basketball in Reggie Arsenault's hand. When you have a player that can create his own shot, as Reggie Arsenault has proven throughout this basketball game, you need to play to him, let the ball go through him, and he has been beyond impressive in this basketball game. He's been phenomenal.
Spent most of his time in North Carolina as a kid after moving from Hurricane Katrina in New Orleans. Here in the Horizon League tonight, with each team with one timeout remaining and neither team close to the bonus, we find Wright State, one of the co-leaders of the conference, ahead of Loyola by one, 62-61, after trailing by 11 and after missing 12 consecutive three-point shots in the first half.
Wow, I mean, you come out, you shoot 13% from the three-point line in the first half, and then in the second half, you're shooting over 70% from the three-point line. That's pretty good, but I think in the situation right now, and if I'm Loyola, the only person I want touching the basketball to start off with is Ben Averkamp. Play through him, let the other guy spot up, but I think he's your best offensive option right now for Loyola.
Averkamp wears number 24 for the Ramblers, and defending him is Tavares Sledge, who has four personal fouls. A little cleanup duty near the Wright State bench, and then we'll resume play. Porter Moser claps the hands at the top of the screen. He's the head coach of the Ramblers in a very successful second season. Raiders only their second lead of the game. Fifteen on the possession clock. Devin Turk. Contact. Team foul number 6 on Wright State, a non-shooting foul, so the ball is out of bounds to the Ramblers. Second foul on Reggie Arsenal, the next team foul on Wright State. Means a bonus. Full shot clock, reset at 35. And looks, did he get it in? Did he get a timeout? Ramblers get a full timeout, that's their last. Again, to indicate why this game is of so much significance, we visit the Rising League standings. 16-game season for each team, and Wright State with a win tonight will go 4-0 and put itself in a pretty good spot, namely winning its first road game and completing a quarter of the season. Although Billy Donlin, the head coach, said earlier today, all we've done in winning three games at home is hold serve. Now for the Ramblers, Ben Averkamp, you've been harping on this all second half. He's got to get some touches.
Well, he's a guy that can do so much on the basketball court, inside, outside, and really Wright State has not had an answer for him when he's had his touches. And you're going to see the whole offensive repertoire that he has in his basketball game. He's a very difficult matchup. He's a big that can step out and shoot it. He can take a smaller guy down in the post and use all the spin moves that he has. He's a tough matchup, and I think Loyola has gotten away from him at times, Jim, in the second half. Right now in this situation, you're down one, a minute 07, which is plenty of time, but you want your best offensive player to touch the basketball.
He's also a good free throw shooter at 82%. Coming up next, E60 here on ESPNU, and tomorrow, full slate of college basketball. But tonight, couple of thrillers, one earlier tonight from Loyola Maryland and now from Loyola of Chicago. Ramblers led by 10 at the break, as many as 11 early in the second half. Raiders, however, have come back. 107 remains and a full shot clock for the Ramblers. Payne looks for Hicks to Averkamp instead. Averkamp will set himself on the block. Averkamp trying to get position on Sledge, can't do it. Turk open shot, rimmed it. Jordan Hicks with a rebound, blocked. Rebound Darling, contact all over the place. We got a foul on the Ramblers.
And what a man-sized rebound that Cole Darling gets. Not only does he come up with the block, but he came up with a huge defensive rebound for Wright State. You're going to see the block right there, and then the ability to go up, be tough, and get a huge rebound for Wright State. He's been impressive not only on the defensive end, but he's given them some big buckets on the offensive end and the post for Wright State in the second half.
And Malcolm, the Ramblers will get another possession, but now they got to try to D up. 40 seconds left in the game. First place for Wright State is on the line. Now 30 seconds. Arsenal still dribbling, firing way off the mark. Rebound to home to the Ramblers, down by one. No timeouts remaining for Loyola. 15 seconds left. Down to 10. Averkamp with 7. Right hand hook. Missed it. Tip. No. Raiders with a rebound. 2 seconds. Down to the end of the court. Game over. Wright State wins.
What a basketball game, Jim, this was. Can't say enough about how Wright State came back from a really poor first half to come back with toughness, and Reggie Arsenault was the guy for Wright State.
Ramblers did not have a timeout remaining, Malcolm, so they had to operate without a break here, and Averkamp had a good look.
That's a really good look if you're Loyola right there. Averkamp had a little runner in the lane, uncontested, and then a heads-up play that time by Wright State to just throw the ball in the other end with 1 second remaining, and Wright State's going to come up with a huge win on the road.
15-6 run by Wright State to close it out in the last 6.5 minutes. And the Raiders lead the conference at 4-0. Final score, Wright State 62, Loyola 61. For Malcolm Huckabee and our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Jim Barber. Coming up next, E60 on ESPNU. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. So long from Chicago.
Now, E60 on ESPNU. He was one of Vince McMahon's most memorable creations.